Hey, girls.
You know I smoked a lot of grass. Oh Lord.
Hey Shades Babes. I'm kind of getting sick. Good news, I got a job today. My interview, I think it went okay, but she was just like, so why do you think we should, what would you, no, she said, what would you add to our team here? And I was just like, I think it'd be fun. I was horrible. And she just kind of was like, you don't know what you're in for, but, and they have this thing called blackout where after Thanksgiving, all the way till after Christmas, everyone pretty much has to work and you can't ask off. And I'm probably going to be leaving the country for 2 weeks. So I kind of mentioned that, and I don't know. She said that like I might be like one of the only ones who'd get to do something like that. But then also I forgot to tell her that I'm not going to be here Friday, Saturday, Sunday because I'll be a bridesmaid in my cousin's wedding in Missouri. So I hope it all works out. But it's exciting. I haven't had a job since March, and I really need one. And I think it'll be fun to work there. I went to the orthodontist, I think, last week or the week, no, 2 weeks ago. And they said that hopefully around Christmas time I should be getting these things off. That's really exciting. I took this thing called the Strong Interest Survey or something like that, and my results are in this. So I took it online. It was through my school. I took it online, and then I went to this little lunch where they like explained the results. And I have to say, this thing is awesome. It is so cool. If you guys have something like this at your school, take it because it is so fun to look at the results. So they kind of told me some things I already knew, but it's fun to see it in writing. Okay, so this top one is artistic, and that's all the way at 74. And then investigative is the last one, and that's a 37. But, okay, it says, your top 10 strong occupations. Let's start at number 10, shall we? Number 10, community service director. Number 9, restaurant manager. Number 8, surprise, surprise, foreign language teacher. Number 7, advertising account manager. Number 6, broadcast journalist.
Number 5,
buyer.
Number 4,
travel consultant.
Number 3,
retail sales manager.
Number 2,
flight attendant.
Number 1.
Florist. But it says occupations of dissimilar interest. Physicist, mathematician, geologist, biologist, or chemist. Yeah, let's hope I'm not any of those things. So I know what you guys might be thinking. Why does Gloria always make her videos in her room at her house? Well, the answer is because I share a room with someone who we don't really talk to each other, and in my house where we live on campus, anything you say in your room can be heard by pretty much anyone in a room touching yours. So I have a room here, and a room here, and a room underneath me here, and then there. And they can all hear. Like, I can hear their conversations, they can hear mine. And I don't really want to be talking to my computer and talking about stuff and then hearing it. You know what I'm saying? So but I did try. I made a video of me dancing, and my roommate walked in, and I stopped. But, it's really bad. I'll play some of it so you can see my room a little bit. Well, come on and let me know. Should I stay or should I go? Should I stay or should I go now? So, what else? What else? But, yeah. So, last Thursday, Melissa and I went to Freshberry, which if you guys haven't been there, you are missing out. It's on like 111th and Memorial, right by Coney Islander and Starbucks. And it's yogurt, frozen yogurt stuff, but they used to only have the sweet tart, which is the white one, and then the chocolate, the decadent chocolate, or decadent, whatever. And they have those two, and then all the chocolates and candy and fruit, fresh berries that you could have. But now they have mango, pomegranate, low sugar tart, and acai berry or something like that. And they're so delicious. And so last Thursday they had like the customer appreciation thing introducing their new flavors. And they had not the small serving, not the medium, but the large serving for free with one topping for everyone. So it was a very nice night. And I have a coupon. If I get one smoothie, I get another smoothie free. So I want to go do that soon. And I love it. And someone's calling me. Hello? Well, I got the job. Are you surprised? So last Thursday night, there was a showing of the Tom's Shoes documentary. It was really, really cool. I went with 3 people from TU. Fact. Lie is... Okay. Did you guys know? Did you know? Okay, and here is my fact for the video. A lie is usually manifested by these signs. A sudden increase in the number of ums and uhs. Overly defensive, no eye contact. Lying is stressful. They will try to be sarcastic, turning his or her body away from you, talking fast, making statements that contradict each other, unusual body language, or a hand reaching to cover the mouth. Well, that stinks. I do all those things almost all the time, but I don't think I'm lying. Baby. So, my girls, Casey, I hope Colorado's doing great. I can't wait to see you when you come in town. Carly, I hope Kansas is fun. I saw some of your pictures with your friends on your floor and they look really cute. And I haven't seen you the past time you came in town, so we need to hang out next time. And Megan, saw you Saturday night. You're lovely. Want to see you soon. And Melissa, what's up, girl? You asked me what my favorite Kook song was, and I said, I already miss you, and you said, oh, Gloria, and I said, that's my favorite song, girl! Just kidding. But why'd you want to know my favorite song? Well, yeah. Hey, well, y'all come back! What are you guys gonna be for Halloween? You're gonna see what I'm gonna be. It's gonna be cool. Okay, I don't know why I keep talking like... But I don't feel very good, guys. You know, I've seen a lot of people walking around with tombstones in their eyes. Getting up a dime of dirt. What do you want from me? All right. Bye.